So what is the result of the serpent's work? What will be the results? 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 1. Now the Spirit expressly says that in the latter times some will depart from the faith. Underline that. Depart from the faith. Giving heed to. Please underline the next sentence. Giving heed to. Deceiving spirits and doctrines of demons. Number one, some will depart from the faith, meaning they will fall away. Fall away from following the Lord Jesus Christ. And 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 3 says, there's coming a great falling away in the last days. Coming. And we are already seeing it. People leaving the church. People even who once upon a time were good, spirit-filled people. Coming out to say, I no longer follow Christ. Have you heard that? Some very prominent worship leaders in the US have said it publicly. I no longer want to follow Christ. What's happening? Falling away. A great church leader in Europe who founded the largest church in Europe called Ulf Ackman. At the height of his pastorship, he renounced, I no longer believe in Christ, I believe in Mary. And he joined the Roman Catholic Church. He founded the largest Pentecostal church in Europe. Fall away. A few years ago, I have those records. Some prominent evangelical church leaders in the US went all the way to the Vatican and kissed the ring of Pope. Do you know that? Prominent evangelical leaders. Their names will shock you. Evangelical and charismatic. What's happening? Falling away has started. Number one. Number two, giving heed. What does it mean, giving heed? Means moving toward or embracing. So gradually, they will release what they had learned formally and believed formally and switch over to focus on something else. Stray away. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 13 says, evil seducers will increase in the last days. Evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. First they get deceived, then they deceive others. Through whom will deception come? The devil. But he doesn't come personally to you, right? He uses agencies. Three kinds. Number one, false Christ. Matthew chapter 24 verse 5. Many will come in my name saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. So when such people come, it will be very easy for us to identify, because you will never believe anyone who says, I am the Christ. Right? Okay, good. This is very easy. Secondly, false prophets. Matthew chapter 24 verse 11. Then many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. Now when these false prophets come, 99% of Christians will fall. Why? Because, now, okay, before I tell you about false prophet, because this false prophet was once upon a time a good prophet. A good prophet who came to your church, a good prophet whose messages you heard on YouTube, you're following his teachings, and then he strayed away, and you didn't know that. You didn't know that he had strayed away. And you will pay heed to the false visions and the prophecies this false prophet will give. Jeremiah chapter 14 verse 14. And false signs, wonders and miracles. Mark chapter 13 verse 22. So we should not also run after signs and wonders, miracles taking place in this crusade and that crusade. They are genuine works of God. And the genuine works of God will be attested by the fruit of the Spirit in the man of God's life. Where he is not boastful or attracts attention to himself, giving all the glory to God. And they live such a godly lives. Not drinking booze after the meetings. Right? So what is the goal of a false prophet? To cause Christians to go astray from following true doctrines. That is their goal. Thirdly, false teachers. 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 1. But there were also false prophets among the people, even as there will be false teachers among you, who will secretly bring in destructive heresies, even denying the Lord who brought them, and bring on themselves swift destruction. Now this is another one difficult to identify, because once upon a time they were good teachers. False prophets were once upon a time a true prophet. False teacher once upon a time was a true teacher. So when they begin to teach destructive heresies, you will fall. Let me share with you some doctrines of demons that are presently floating in the body of Christ that are taught by false teachers and prophets. Number one, hypergrace. I'm sure you already are familiar with the hypergrace gospel, where they say everyone has been forgiven, which is technically correct. But this hypergrace goes on to say even all your future sins are already forgiven, which means no matter how filthy a lifestyle you live, no matter what evil that you do, they are already forgiven. So just go on living as you are. Hypergrace. Is it right or wrong? Hypergrace. Secondly, the doctrine of immortality. Have you heard of that? No. This has been creating havoc in India during the COVID-19 period. Now, what is the immortality doctrine? It's nothing new. The very lie the devil told Eve, you will not die. And the immortality doctrine says you will live forever and ever. Is it true? Even the great apostle Paul died, right? Thirdly, the latest. That's present now. The gospel of inclusion. Have you heard of that? Gospel of inclusion. That gospel teaches that everyone, including gay people, are all in the kingdom of God. No matter what your lifestyle is, you are included in the kingdom of God. That makes a mockery for God to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. Right? And in the book of Revelation, it states very clearly, the abominable, the effeminate, and the gay, the homosexual, will not enter into the kingdom of God. Period. No argument against that. Then where did this gospel of inclusion come from? Doctrine of demons. My dearly beloved brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, the Lord Jesus Christ very strictly warned us in Matthew chapter 24 verse 24 that even the very elect will be deceived. Which means senior saints of God in the church, senior ministers of God, the elect will be deceived. So, what should we do? What is our safety net? Matthew chapter 24, verse 4. And Jesus answered and said to them, take heed that no one deceives you. Take heed means discern. Discern carefully whatever you hear. Any visions, any prophecies, any revelations, any teachings, discern instead of swallowing wholesale. Especially when there are a barrage of teachings on the internet. Please be careful of what you hear on the YouTube. Be careful. Don't just swallow everything like a baby that will start crawling on the ground. Don't behave like that. Be wise and discerning. Attend a good church where your pastor is a true man of God who walks with God and produces the fruit of the Spirit. He's a man of prayer. Attend such a church. Don't just simply attend any church for the sake of attending a church. It's about time you come out of Babylon. About time. Don't stay in Babylon any longer. Come out. God is tired of all the false pastors. And they are deceiving his flock. They are draining his flock. They are milking his flock. And they are destitute of food. That is why there are tons of sheep without shepherd today looking to the internet for church services. Some find good churches, some find wrong churches. You should attend a church which is a praying church. A church that prays is the house of God. Because the Lord Jesus said, my house shall be called a house of prayer. If there is no prayer in our church, don't go to that church. They can have good teaching, good preaching, good singing, good prophesying, good ministry. Don't. It's a lopsided church. Attend a praying church. And make sure the pastor is a praying pastor. And also, the shepherd should be a lover of souls. To reach out to lost souls. Go to such a church where you will grow like a plant that's planted by the rivers of living waters. Amen?